Hey guys, so we're just gonna do a little math today. It's going to be a new microphone setup. So that you can hear all the good pencil and paper sounds, all the sounds, without the microphone picking up all the vibrations from the desk, because when it sits on the stand right here, even though it has this tiny little bit of insulation, it still picks up the vibrations quite a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and put up a short little behind the scenes clip so you guys can see just how ridiculous this setup is. So let's go ahead and open this over here because the microphone's very starting tutoring this fall for mostly high school level math. So I just wanted to do a brief review of some of the concepts in precalculus. So we have our commutative properties, multiplication and addition. Irrespective of are solved, irrespective of their order. And some of these are interesting, going back in hindsight, noticing that these properties I think are useful to know, but don't really require a name, I guess. That's symmetric transitive, the principle of substitution. It's good to know that, but certainly not crucial to know the names so much as to be able to just use them to solve problems. Let's flip to a more practical example. So I suppose this is the review of algebra 1 and 2. this, the proof. Wow, this is actually really cool. Squared money. minus x plus 2. And then we'll simply distribute this one here, here, and here. Get 2x, 2x times x squared is 2. X cubed minus 2x squared plus 4x. And then now we do the same thing. We simply distribute. So we get 5x squared, and I'm going to put it in line with this x squared because we're going to add and subtract like terms. Then we have negative 5x and positive 10. And now we just go ahead and add them. So that's the same here as writing 2x times all that plus 5 times all that right there. And we get that. Now some useful properties or special cases, I guess, when you're looking at problems that involve polynomials being multiplied by each other. One that often pops up is called a difference of squares. And when you see something that looks like, let's see, this, for instance, if you have a difference something that looks like, you can easily take the square root of it, such as 4x squared, the square root of which would be 2x, and 9, the square root of course is 3. Generally, useful manipulation is to expand this out into a addition and subtraction of its respective square roots. Because you'll notice that 2x there. 2x times itself is 4x squared. And then we have 2x minus 3, which is negative 6x. And then we have 3 times 2x, which is positive 6x. can be useful, because, and of course, I think the best way to teach is to make it very clear why the things you are learning are actually kind of going to help you. Because why learn how to use a tool if you're never going to actually need it? So, if you ever see this, it's useful to know that you can break it up into this. If, for instance, you're given this and you're asked to simplify, you can recognize that this can be broken up into this and this. So, as long as you recognize that this is a difference of two squares, you can make this. And the next thing you know, you have these two canceling out because they simply equal 1. They equal 1. Okay. Times. So that's very, very useful to get from this to this. Okay, next. We'll do dividing polynomials. Dividing polynomials. Of course, it's not really that obvious, but I forgot to mention that there is a difference. Cubes. Which would be a cube minus another cube. So we could do 8, 2 times 2. Is helpful because for the same exact reasons that this one was helpful. So I'm running out of time, so just show you this, and if you guys are interested, we'll pick it up a little later. It's starting to rain outside. But 15 goes in the 84.